The Red River and the Northwest Rebellions had a lasting effect upon Canadian society. The question of Aboriginal and Métis rights were brought into question, and the creation of an entire new province came into existence. In 1868, the Métis suffered many problems, chiefly being land and new racist English settlers. Rupert's Land was in the process of being transferred to the Dominion of Canada. As shown, this would be the end result. However, at the time, the legal title of the land that the Métis were living on, chiefly the land that would become Manitoba, was left in question during the transfer of the land from the Orange Order, a vehemently anti-French and anti-Catholic group, which the Métis were, started to arrive in numbers to the Red River area, greatly increasing tensions. These two factors in unison drove the Métis and most famously Louis Riel to fight back, eventually through their struggle and the capture of Fort Garry. Their problems were brought to the attention of the federal government. The effects of this led to the creation of Manitoba and special land grants to the Métis by the government of Canada. However, that would eventually fail and would lead the Métis along with other groups in 1884 to rebel. The land grants that were issued by the government to the Métis were generally sold by them to land speculators, as the Métis did not know what to do with them or were so desperate for the money. Bear in mind that these land grants were exchangeable for cash. For both of these reasons, the Métis, well, most of them however, were forced to move west, with some staying behind. The Aboriginal peoples of the Plains were also being forced off the land in treaties. These treaties with the Canadian government promised natives farming equipment that actually never came. And in return, they forced natives to send their children to residential schools and essentially would give the natives starvation rations in exchange for their land. This caused them to starve in droves, causing discontent among the natives.
Also, new white settlers arriving to the west received some of the worst land available in the region, aggravating tensions between the Canadian government and those new settlers.
Also, for all people who live in the West, Native, Native, or White, they all lacked political representation in Ottawa, and that provided a united front for the Northwest Rebellion to begin. In the end, the Northwest and Red River Rebellions has had causes that profoundly shaped Canada then as it does now. Even today, the questions of residential schools, Métis, and Native relations still surround us. With that, history still needs to be made.